is this topic called as transaction risks and conflict resolution. Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss a topic called as contractual risk and conflict resolution, which comes under the subject of called as procurement and supply, or under a topic called as business negotiations and contracts. So what we should understand first, what is contract? A contract is an agreement that is enforceable at law, and not at all the agreements can be a contract. Right? As well as a contract is a tool to govern relationships between the parties, because contract occurs between the parties. Right? So therefore that, if you understand, except all the contract can be an agreement, but all the agreements cannot be a contract, as it shows clear relationship and governs clear relationship between the two parties which has entered into a contract. For that thing, we should understand what are the components of a contract. So the components of a contract should always have a legal capacity, right? It should always have a legal capacity in terms of age, competency, individuals, signing, right? So the second component is offer and acceptance. Right? Offer and acceptance, that both the parties should accept the offer and accept the contract. Then only it will be a valid contract. Then there should be always a contract to always have a consideration. Consideration that in return for a promise, whether whatsoever you have agreed on. Then there should be a legal purpose for the contract. That also should be clearly understood. What is the legal purpose of the contract? Any illegality should not be included in the contract. Then conditions. Conditions related to the government rules and regulations. Rules and regulations related to the aspects for which the contract is being made, for the business for which the contract is being, which should be clearly followed. So these components should always be there in contract, which should make the contract a valid contract. Then contract life cycle, which is also called as CLC. Contract life cycle is very much essential and necessary, because it means without having a contract life cycle management, we cannot properly manage the contract or the agreement between the two parties, that is the relationship between the two. Because at each stage we can clearly check and find out that where can be the risk and reduce that risk or eliminate that risk. That risks can be financial risk or legal or procurement risk. So there should be a good contract life cycle management, which helps us to manage the contract and agreement between the two parties. What can be the risks between them when we talk about the contract life cycle? And for the risks and the creations and authorization, which is called as written drafted contract. When we have a written drafted contract, we can clearly and properly manage it. There should be collaboration and negotiation, one of the elements where through which we can internally review the language and the contents approved by the parties. Then the contract should be properly executed. That means final draft, communication, signing, uploading, and storage. That execution of the contract should be properly done. Then there is an element called as administration, that is properly monitoring in the contract with the renewal dates and performance. Then closure out or renewal and analysis. Then performance analysis, termination and renewal. That means whenever we are closing the contract, we should understand how it performed, what was the performance of that contract. Do you want to renew it? Do you want to retender it? Do you want to close the contract because it didn't perform well? These are the particularities which should be understood. Then coming on to various stages. There are 9 stages in a contract lifecycle management which should always be followed. What are those? First is request for a contract. Then review and rewriting or review or redlining the contract. That is reviewing, clearly getting the approval of the contract. Then execution of the contract properly with all the rules and regulations. Storage of the contract, recording management, that is recording of that contract and properly managing that all the records are properly managed at each and every stage. Then search and retrieval of that contract, audit and reporting that the contract has been performed well or all the documents have been duly submitted related to that contract or not. Renewal and disposition of that contract, whether you want to renew it or you want to close it. And then again back to the first stage, which is contract renewal request, whether you want to start a new contract or you want to renew that. Then also if you want to renew it, again that contract request has to be put out. So there are 9 stages. stages which has to be followed in a contract life cycle management, which means every contract or agreement between the two parties' relationship a successful contract. So that's all for today.